Well, but, you know, last time when I heard you playing how many children and kids?
Yes.
Five, four or five?
Yeah.
Something like that, yeah. Well, that's etudes, where, you know, in a way, pianists are always extremely interested. Let's say if you go to competition, and the jury is always very amazed by, you know, the technique in the Chopin etude, something like that. But in a piece like this, your musical ideas almost have to stand alone. You know what I mean? Without the help of the astonishment of people listening to you. Because this is really pure interpretation. It's your own character that you give to it, your own fantasia that you give to it. And I would like to urge you to play with as much fantasia as possible. So that really can, well, Fasching Schwankhaus, I mean, is of course the carnival of Vienna, so you can imagine all kinds of things, and all kinds of things, but it won't do us any good to talk about the visual imagery, because you have to suggest it all in the dancing, and the music, and the song, and the dances that you play. So, I need to find your inner involvement more. There's something that keeps me listening. As a listener, I need to feel it. Okay? And it's got to be really, really strong coming from you. I don't mean that you're playing a stronger sound, that's not what I mean. I mean that your communication is the strongest.
But I'd like to hear it again.
It's a short piece, it's a fairly short piece, it's not very long. But let's talk our way through it a little bit. Very, very festive, the opening, right? Yes. You might fix it if it's okay.
Let's try it.
your cousin?
Yeah.
You have two cousins?
Yeah.
Are they the same person?
No.
Okay, try again. Now, as I'm asking you to do these things, I'm speaking to you very specifically as one musician to another. You obviously understand exactly what I'm talking about. And I remember that from the last class we did, you responded immediately. So you clearly have the fantasia. So I'm not going to try to psychoanalyze you as to why it didn't come out the first time. Maybe something to do do you believe that there's such a thing as good pianists and bad pianists? Kind of, yes and no. I also kind of believe it. I mean, I wouldn't kind of say that, okay, there's only art and not piano playing. Because obviously the mechanics of playing well is extremely important to become, to let the artist inside of you speak. That's true. But I think you have to be more engaged from your inside with the imagination, the quality of what's in the music itself. You know, a guy like you shouldn't have to be, I know I shouldn't say it, having to be proving themselves playing. Which agents did you have to play? Crummer? Come on, you know, I mean, if I were you, I would learn the Faschingschlagerspiel and the Fantasy, or the Faschingschlagerspiel and the Carnival. Well, you played the Carnival already, then, right? No. I'll bet you can play it now. You can play it now from the first book. That's what I mean. That was great. Play it for me. You want to do something on that chord? But you're doing this. But I know you wanted, you felt that the quality of that chord is different from that. But you did it by doing it softer, which is okay. But you're.
Schumann is not a pianistic composer.
Schumann is musician, great musician. I'm not speaking generally, I'm speaking about something very specific. Nachman is pedaling every bar.
Thank you.
Schumann is always writing these very complicated, as if he was always behind in life, and maybe he was always behind in life. So he's always writing the beat a little bit behind. You know, it's written, and usually when people hear it, we think it's, but you know, and there's so many places, hundreds of places in Schumann where he's writing music in a similar way. You know, in the toccata also. So, can you play that?
Thank you.
because I think you feel these things, but if you're a little bit afraid because you're afraid somebody's going to point a finger at you and say, that's a bad taste. No, it's very good, but that would be good. Yes, and then from there.
Thank you.
you're basically paddling each bar. No, but then we don't hear the slur. The A's
thank you. not really saying what I think. I don't think that what I'm doing is in bad taste. I just almost don't think that bad taste exists. I think not recognizing the inner tension of the music is worse than playing with bad taste. That's what I think. And I think you have to risk to put your neck out so that it can be chopped off a little bit more. This harmony here, this guy here.
Thank you.
to what you're listening to as you practice. You know what I mean? I mean, I certainly don't think that I have all the right answers. I hear when I'm playing now, I have to think about this a little bit more. But when you're practicing, you just have to ask yourself, am I hearing all that's there? This is the main point.
Yes.
Okay. I want to go on. Yeah, it has to be in a completely another world, this kind of other world of Schumann's sonnet. And you have to keep your listener awake at the same time, but you're putting them into this kind of sphere. They can't go to sleep when they're tired. It's very difficult. Can you play that?
Thank you.
shadow.
Thank you.
Schumann wrote.